All right, Reality Check viewers, I'm here with the mighty, one and only Mr. Mark Mendoza. How are you, brother?
What's up? How are you?
It's very good to see you as always. You're here every year.
Another year at NAMM, huh?
It's a beautiful
another
thing.
Freaking year. Twisted Sister schedule's coming in. I play in two other bands. I play in, you know, check it out, Joe Rock and the All-Stars. Go on and on Facebook. It's a local band. He's a great friend of mine. He's a very popular local DJ, Joe
yes,
Rock.
I know
Joe
Rock.
He's here today, too.
Cool.
And we may even play someplace. There's talk of us playing as a band today.
Cool.
But check it out on Facebook, Joe Rock and the All-Stars. Go to markmendoza.net, see what I'm doing. Always
yes.
Go to twistedsister.com. How's that for pushing my own stuff?
Everything. We love that. Shameless self-promotion.
You have a specific question for me?
I have a specific question for you.
Well, it better be good.
It better be. Oh, no, the pressure is on.
Mic someplace that's uncomfortable.
Oh, maybe I should just bend over now.
No, it's a good question. You got
it. It's a good question. You've been a Harkey endorser all pretty much your entire career, have you not?
No, but since Twisted Sister got back together in 2003, yes.
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 And that started with the whole New York Steel thing, speaking of charity benefits, the biggest one of all.
Yeah, the 9/11 one.
That was incredible.
Right, New York Steel. Somebody approaches JJ. It was actually, what's his name?
Eddie Trunk.
Thank you. This is Alzheimer's setting in. A little dementia.
We're all getting old. We're at NAMM or something.
Who the hell are you?
I don't know.
Why am I talking to you? Right. I mean, D makes a joke on stage sometimes when he introduces the guys in the band. He says something about him, and he gets to me, and he goes, and we're in front of like 70,000 people in Europe, and he goes, see this guy over here? Our first rehearsal, he showed up with a gun. Now, yeah, I did.
Yeah,
I did. But it wasn't. It had nothing to do with showing up, because if I had to kick some ass, I don't need a gun. I came from a position that day that required me to carry a gun. And I didn't go home first, because I usually don't carry it around all the time. You know, I'm licensed to, I'm allowed to, but, you know, do I look like I need a gun?
No.
No. So, but I happened to have it to go to rehearsal, and I took my jacket off, and there's my gun on my hip.
And wait, let's get a shot of the jacket.
And I'm like, oh, this is not a good thing. This is not a way to start getting back together.
Right.
But anyway, it's been a happy thing since then. The natural part in front of a camera, it doesn't scare me.
I don't care, right?
Does this camera bother me? Hey. All right.
Sir.
That's it?
Always a pleasure. Unless you have something else you want to add.
No, I'm just saying, you figured you had a lot of good questions, man. You're supposed to be a good interviewer.
I am a good interviewer sometimes.
This was good? No, it was good. It was good. It's great, man. Make sure you catch this. Pay attention and listen to this man. And hopefully he doesn't run out of air.